Good morning. It's Monday, October 25th. I'm Tammy Trujillo, and you're listening to the LA Report from KPCC and LAist.com. Here's your morning news. Heavy rains in the forecast mean we all need to be on the watch for dangerous debris flows, especially if you live near an area that burned in the past few years. KPCC science reporter Jacob Margolis has more.
Water moving fast downhill picks up boulders, trees, and mud, creating an unstoppable wall of nature that can move cars like they're toys and destroy houses with ease. Wildfires make debris flows more likely, as hillsides stripped of vegetation leave soil to be battered and carried away by rain. We've got a whole lot of places right now, like the Alisal Fire burn area, that are especially vulnerable. You should prepare for possible debris flows by getting together emergency supplies and anticipate having to leave in the middle of the night with little notice. Covering science, I'm Jacob Margolis.
Following a small sewage spill in Huntington Beach last week and a much bigger 17-million-gallon one this summer near Dockweiler Beach, the Aquarium of the Pacific wants to draw more attention to the issue. It's partnered with the group called the Ocean Sewage Alliance. Stephanie Ware is senior scientist for the Nature Conservancy and an aquarium board member. She says sewage pollution is killing coral reefs and causing health problems for people.
If you're a surfer in California, you are very likely to have had some weird infection that you experienced. And this could have been due to exposure to sewage outflows or some sort of contamination event in the waters.
She hopes to bring more visibility to ocean sewage pollution by having the aquarium on board.
They have this commitment to not only sharing the wonders of marine life in the ocean, but also what kind of problems are we facing and what can be done about it.
She says if you want to do your part, make sure not to put anything down the sink or toilet like medications or hygiene products. An In-N-Out restaurant in the Bay Area has been fined for failing to enforce a local mandate requiring employees at restaurants to indoor dining check customers' vaccination status. From California Hub member station, KALW in San Francisco, Suni Khalid has more.
According to SFGate, Contra Costa County's health department has penalized an In-N-Out Burger restaurant in Pleasant Hill this week for failing to screen its customers for a proof of vaccination. SFGate reports the restaurant has been fined twice in the last 2 weeks, totaling $750, although it added that there are no plans to close the restaurant. The In-N-Out Burger at Fisherman's Wharf was closed by the San Francisco Department of Public Health last week following complaints for the same offense, according to multiple reports. The restaurant reopened, but only for outdoor or takeout dining. A representative for In-N-Out released a statement saying the chain, quote, refuses to become the vaccination police for any government, unquote. The spokesman added the county's order was, quote, unreasonable, invasive, and unsafe, unquote. In Oakland, I'm Suni Khalid.
Healthcare workers were honored at a mass at the Cathedral of Our Lady of the Angels yesterday. The annual healthcare professionals mass is known as the White Mass, named for the white lab coats worn by many medical workers. The special service was held in person and streamed online. And while taking on extra significance in the pandemic, the mass in honor of all medical workers dates back to the late 1800s. Thank you for listening to the LA Report. I'm Tammy Trujillo. Join us again next time. And meanwhile, you can get more news on LAist.com and listen live at